Tim, my new bank card's come.
Hey, Fran.
Well, make sure you bring that on Wednesday, Fran.
Luke's playing.
Just to tell everyone, since I've had my second vaccine on Tuesday, Fran just reminded me to tell you all that I've had my second jab.
Oh, that's brilliant. Hi, Marie.
Hello. Oh, I have to my radio.
Oh, I've just realised I'm called Joelle. I'll be younger. Right, let's get started then. Let's rock and roll because we've got a busy programme. Good to see everybody. How amazing was it to be back at the club today coaching the juniors? Me and Pedro were loving it, and Morskin was brilliant too, wasn't it, Tim?
Fantastic. Yeah,
Nick was there all day.
Oh, Nick's there. Sorry, Nick, I didn't see
that. What happened at Morskin, Nick?
Great recruiting work. Really well organised. I mean, it was really brilliantly organised, and it was so smoothly, went smoothly, and really good ground for recruiting. Got a couple of disabled players.
Oh, that's what we watched. You know, I was going to text really you, Nick, for that. Yeah.
It's great recruiting ground. We really enjoyed it. It was good. Thanks for Tim and everyone. Going well so far. Day one gone.
Charlie organised.
Can I ask you a question about disability? I've got a friend in a wheelchair who wants to play table tennis. Can she join the club and be part of a group or something?
Oh, I'm sure we can work that out, Susie. Yeah.
Could be. There's ramps. We have had wheelchair table tennis before.
Yeah, she used to play table tennis in her youth and then she got... a problem with her back, and then she ended up in a wheelchair. But she'd love to play table tennis again.
Pedro's doing work with disabled kids in wheelchairs. We should be able to accommodate it in principle.
Okay, well, I'll tell her that we're working on it, and that it should eventually be accommodated.
Okay. Yeah, tell her to get in contact, Susie, and then we get contact details. And yeah, brilliant.
Okay. Yeah, I will. Thank you.
Right, let's get going then. So let's do a quick daily check-in then. So should we see thumbs up if you've had a great day, thumbs here if it's been okay, thumbs down if it's been... Oh, I'm loving Lucy's enthusiasm there and Chris O's. Yeah, I've got to say a good day because we were brilliant coaching at the club. Loved it. Oh, everyone's happy. That's amazing. So let's go straight to Robert. So nice to see you, Robert. And you are going to start us off with a song, which we've not had for a long time. Oh, Tim had just unmuted you.
You're muted, Robert.
Can you unmute yourself, Robert? Oh.
No.
I've not got a great connection, Teresa. Everyone can unmute themselves if they want to.
Oh, they should
Robert,
do.
Can you unmute yourself?
Can you unmute yourself? Hello. Oh, there he is. Yeah, there you are. Hi, Robert.
Hello. Hope you enjoyed this. This is from Les Miserables.
Ooh, lovely. Ooh.
And now I'm all alone again, no one's a turn, no one's a virtue. Without a home, without a friend, without a face to say hello to. And now the night is near, and I can make believe she's here. Sometimes I walk alone at night when everybody else is sleeping. I think of her and then I'm happy with the company I'm keeping. The city goes to bed and I can live inside my head. On my own, pretending she beside me, all alone, I walk with her till morning. without her. I feel her arms around me, and when I lose my way, I close my eyes, and she's found me. In the rain, the pavement shines like silver. All the lights are misty in the river. In the darkness, the trees are full of starlight, and all I see is her and me, forever and forever. And I know it's only in my mind that I'm talking to myself and not to her. And although I know that she is blind, still I say there's a way for us, my love, for. And when the night is over, she is gone. The river's just a river. Without her, the water around me changes. The trees are there and everywhere. The streets are full of strangers. I love her, but every day I'm learning. All my life I've only been pretending. Without me, a world will go on turning. A wonderful happiness that I will never know.
Oh, that was beautiful, Robert. Thank you so much. I love Lemiz.
Beautiful.
Thank you, Lisa.
Lots of nice comments. Oh, hi, Harry. Here comes our co-host, Harry.
I'll see you next week.
Oh, bye, Robert.
Well done, Robert.
And I'll sing for you next week. I'll send you a text, Teresa.
Okay, thank you. Right. Bye-bye. Hi, Harry. What's next, then?
Hi, Teresa. I'm sorry. I was nervous.
That's okay.
So, next one is Tweet with Fran Reynolds and the news about Trace Air in February.
Yeah.
Tim, could you let me share screen, please? Thank you. And also, it was someone's birthday on Saturday as well.
Wow.
But we'll get to that in a minute. So, happy Easter, everyone. 2 weeks ago. This week there are going to be 6 pictures. All you have to do is guess the picture. Please put your answers in the chat, and also if you don't want to, you can shout out the answers. As Alexis went to do a photo shoot of Lorraine Kelly, I was thinking, why not do a quiz on celebrities? Also, Saturday was Alexis's birthday. And what better way than to ask Alexis to help me? Are you ready, Alexis?
Yep, ready.
Ready.
Who is this celebrity?
Oh, who can type the fastest?
Lorraine Kelly.
Serena.
It is, yay.
Nice picture.
Is that your photo, Alexis?
Is that Alexis' picture? Not one of mine.
No.
Who is this celebrity?
I know him. Can't type quick and fast.
Oh, it's Pippa.
No, oh, that's Pippa. Gary Barlow.
Gary Barlow. I can't type fast enough.
Who is this celebrity? Oh,
Emma Watson.
That was Lucy, I think.
Yes, I think that was Lucy.
Oh, Lucy, Harry Potter fan.
I can't. I'm just a fan.
Who is this celebrity? And we played one of his songs on the Thursday radio show.
Ooh.
Oh, no, Davey Wakeford.
Yeah.
Who was the first?
Who's, oh, it was a BTTC host to everyone.
Harry.
Oh, definitely.
Paula Radcliffe.
Yeah.
I saw her when I come
to the
And who is the celebrity?
Katy Perry.
No, it isn't.
Danny Minogue.
Pippa says Danny Minogue. I don't know who it is.
No, it's Lisa Stansfield.
Ooh, oh, that was a hard one, Fran.
That was difficult.
And those were the answers.
Oh, good quiz.
Next week's quiz, I think, is going to be about Little Britain.
No. Not Little Britain, please.
So, Saturday, I did a festival online, and I'd like to share with you guys about it. I'm going to share screen again. Not for that, but for this one. And there's also a few photos which I found. So, Friends of You for Grace Sayre Friendship E-Fest. For the Grace Sayre Friendship Group, which was on Saturday from midday till 10 p.m. on Zoom, the Grace Sayre Friendship Group had a fest, which is a festival online. Team Dominica and Carousel took part. Carousel did a video in which I am in, but I can't find the video that they did. Team Dominica talked about what they do, and they also did a quiz about coffee.
Oh, we ought to do that. We ought to do a coffee quiz.
I had a good time. There was also a disco there. There was also another quiz, which I did. There was one question about Harry, who is the first qualified table tennis coach of Down syndrome in the UK. And of course, the answer was Harry. I also did a PowerPoint about arts and pets. I did ask Grace Sayre Friendship Group if we do it eFest to include you guys. Any questions?
Oh, it sounds like you had a great time, Fran. Oh,
and I'll show you guys the photos.
See your photos.
So the first one is... Yes, Pippa?
I've got a question for you, Fran. Can you remember any of the questions in the coffee quiz?
Yeah, it's important.
Because I think we should ask Steve if he knows the answer.
Oh,
I can't remember.
I drink enough. First thing I did today.
One, because me and Fran are with Chris.
Chris says Josh.
Me and Fran and the other housemate, Josh, we go on the Zoom with Grace there and we talk about what we
need. This is
the
Team Dominica photo.
Yeah. Oh, all the coffee beans.
Charlie and Georgia. This is the carousel video.
It's nice and colourful.
This is the disco. And that's the PowerPoint which I did, Mind Wellbeing. And the disco, I think. And the art again. And my quiz.
You're very good with the IT. Disco.
And the disco afterwards. Mind Being. And that's... Is that it?
Oh, yeah.
That's it. And that's all the photos.
Oh, Fran, thank you so much for sharing that with us. That's okay. Well done, Fran. Fab stuff. Right, Harry, what's next?
The hairdressers.
Thank you, Fran. Next one is Dan Finish with yourself then.
Oh, thanks, Harry. This song I've chose, because I thought it was Alexis' birthday or something. So I know Alexis rocks all the time with me, and I'm dedicated this song to him. This is I Will Rock You. I Always Rock You, Alexis Marion by Queen.
Oh,
Oh, oh, can we do the
right.
Everyone needs to be up. Buddy, you're a boy, make a big noise. Playing in the street, gonna be a big man someday. You got mud on your face, you big disgrace. Kicking your can all over the place. Singing, we will rock you. A big disgrace, waving your banner all over the place. We will rock you. Sing it, oh, we will rock you. Buddy, you're an old man, poor man, pleading with your eyes, gonna make you zombie someday. You got mud on your face, big disgrace. Somebody better put your bag into your place.
Ned one in a bit of personal diary with a notice, and he'll be his birthday coming up very soon. And Nicky.
Yay!
Hey, we've not done this for ages, have we?
No, we haven't, no.
Right.
Let's see, one of the pictures. Oh, sorry.
Hi, everyone.
Let me get this. There you go.
Right, so it's a while ago, obviously, that this was set, but the photo gallery was, the subject was buildings and architecture, and we have 14 entries, and this week, obviously, I've been building my strength up. Thank you for your gorgeous photos. We have 14 participants, and we'll be showcasing in the following categories: composition, technique, and architecture. Well, buildings as well, but mainly architecture.
Ready?
Yeah. Teresa, here we have the Amex Stadium. I think this is brilliant shot, and not just because it's in black and white, obviously being slightly biased towards black and white. I think it shows so many different kinds of architecture. It shows the lines, the sky is fantastic. I was really, really impressed when I saw this. You've got straight lines going along. You've got the vents, the poles. I just think this is a perfect, taking just part of the building, which is kind of what I wanted. And it's really, really strong. So well done, Teresa.
Guess you like that one.
Yeah, I like that one, yeah. Chris O, fantastic photograph of the windmill there. Beautiful blue sky. I don't know what you call them. Are they the blades? I can't remember. Anyway, the bits that go round on a windmill. Sails. Sorry, I forgot.
The four sails.
The four sails. Thank you very much, Steve.
Thank you.
And
it's a small mill, right. By the way.
just a really strong dynamic shot of an old-fashioned architecture. And the moon just at the top there as well, which just makes the shot. So well done, Chriso. Steve D. Oh, this is a bit spooky. I like this one. This reminds me of a scene from the film The Shining, with a long corridor stretching away, and you've got it perfectly symmetrical. Absolutely fantastic. There's the rug stretching all the way to the end there. What lies beyond the door? The suggestion of what lies beyond there. The lines at the top.
straight as well. I would never have got this straight. It would have been totally wonky. So, Steve D, I think this is a really evocative, a really interesting shot. So, fantastic. Jez, I had to sit here and look at this. Was a very late entrance, by the way, Jez. but we...
He's a very naughty boy, I told him.
He is a very naughty boy. We managed to sneak it in, but only just. But it is a fantastic take on the wind turbine. And I think this is an amazing shot. Through the grills, I assume they're safety grills to stop people climbing up. I really don't know. I photographed wind turbines myself and I don't remember seeing the grills at the bottom. I just think this is a fantastic shot and makes you look 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 times at it before you can sort of really work out what's going on. And again, taking a piece of architecture. So brilliant shot. Andrew, great shot down at the end of Kemptown there. You can see the pier in the distance and Worthing. You've got a perfectly straight horizon, which I applaud you for, because that can't have been easy. And Volks Railway down on the left-hand side, Duke's Mound stretching down there. And the clouds are fantastic. So you've even got sort of natural architecture, I think, with the clouds. So, Andrew, really, really super shot.
Brilliant.
Liz, we had to look up Chiotes and we still don't. We assume it's toilets. and obviously it says toilet above. I don't know where this was taken, but it's a great, it reminds me of some of my African travels where there's been kind of barbershops in the middle of nowhere with sort of homemade signs. I really, really like this. I think it's really, really, the colours are wonderful. It's funny as well. There's some classy toilets for you. So I'm glad I didn't have to use them. Oh, Fran, this is a lovely shot of you with, I can't remember where this was taken, but it's a wonderful shot of you looking really happy in
it's
the door.
The Wealden Downland Museum near Chichester.
Oh, thank you for letting me.
I could tell you who took it. It was the person that's taken me on Wednesday.
Ah. Oh,
brilliant.
And I just think it's a really strong, happy, lovely shot. And then you've got the ladder on the wall sort of pointing towards you. And the way you're framed as well. So you must commend the person who's taking you out on Wednesday on being a really good photographer as well. So well done, Fran. Brilliant. Lenora, well, what an iconic photograph. You know, we've all seen it in various angles and various different ways. And I really like this one with the people all in one corner and then the people in the other corner at the bottom. Straight horizon, just, I think, fantastic. And it's strange, isn't it, how the pier, the West Pier, has become such a recognizable and important part of Brighton, despite what it's gone through. And I think this is a really strong, great shot. So well done, Lenora. Lucy, I really like this. I think it's the old cinema in Kemptown. I may be wrong. I usually am. Or an old church even. I can't remember. But I think it's the sun reflecting off.
It's in Hove. It's sorry. It's where the Pink Floyd guy has just bought it and transformed
Dave
it.
Dave Gilmore's house.
Oh, is it? Yeah. Oh, I was close. Yeah. Then obviously, wrong end of town. Oh, well, I mean, he's obviously got some, he's obviously quite a wealthy person and he's done a really nice job on there. And it's a great photograph. I really, really like the way the photo works, the way it points to the sky, the way that, is that Lucy in the bottom there?
Susie.
Is it Susie or Lucy?
Lucy took the photo.
Lucy took the photo, so it must be Susie.
Yes.
I think, and the sun reflecting off the window. I'm a big fan of sun reflecting off one of the windows on a building. So really, really well done, Lucy. Serena, fantastic photograph. Every different window, almost every different window tells a story. You've got the cranes, you've got the reflections of the pub there in the bottom corner. It's just really strong. And again, it's taking a piece of architecture out, as it were, you know, cutting into it, and very, very strong, very, very impressive. I love it. As always, Serena, a great photo. Juliet, I don't know if Juliet's on the show. What I like about this is that it's such a sort of, and I don't mean this in a bad way, it's such a normal photograph of sort of suburban life. And yet, because of that, no one would normally sort of choose to photograph it, I don't think. And so you can look at it and think, yeah, there's, and you know, you've got the lines coming from the lamppost, the shadows on the road stretching round. You've got all the different kinds of shapes that the suburban buildings build. I think it's a very, very strong shot. So well done, Juliet.
Just had a text from Harry to say, will we show his? But Harry, we couldn't find yours. We don't think we got one from you for this week.
Oh. Yeah, Harry, we're really sorry. We couldn't find yours.
I did send you a very Italian picture of a job with three people, Tim, Harry and Manuai.
Yeah, that was sent before we set the buildings and architecture brief theme. So
sorry, Harry, we didn't think they were for the gallery because they weren't of buildings.
Yeah,
really sorry Harry.
We'll show them next time. How about that?
Okay.
Sorry, Harry.
Are you finished on this one?
Yes, finished on that. Well done, Juliet. Felicity. Right. Okay. So we go from Juliet's sort of picture of suburbia to Felicity's photograph. I think she said this is photographed in Genoa. And what, look at that fantastic over-the-top Baroque architecture with the gold and the pillars leading up. I think this is a really strong shot. And again, another way of looking at architecture, you know, not just looking at eye level, but looking up and seeing what's around. So well done, Felicity. Susie, this makes you do a double take. This is quite a spooky one, I think. I love the fact that you've got the headlight from the car in the foreground. And then the pavilion just sort of appearing over the top of the trees there. It is the pavilion, isn't it? Yes, it is, yeah. And I think, and then the mixing with the natural world, with the tree. So the sort of the mixture of the two really works. So I think you should be really proud of this. So well done, Susie. Pippa in Buckingham Park, where I stood and froze yesterday watching my son lose at football. But I didn't manage to find this building. I wish I had done. It's really intriguing because it's just the front there. You can see the sky through the top windows. So I think this is, you know, to see this and take this is fantastic. And Pippa, you should be, again, I use this term too many times, but you should be really proud. This week's been fantastic. Everyone has really, really taken good photos. Well done, Pippa. And the shots that best fit the categories, and I wish I could say that, you know, have everyone here, but we can only show a few. For composition, we have Chriso and we have Steve. So if we could hear from them, please, that would be great.
Let's have Chriso first.
I'm still here. So that shot was taken at the windmill walk. When I went the other week, the wind was passing forward or backwards, and the windmill was just standing there, and I just took myself halfway down, took the shot, and I thought with the moon, and was just magical, and then I thought that could have been the best photo I've taken, and because that windmill shows that I go up there every day, but we go up there once a week now because of my absence. So that's the best picture yet.
Oh, well done, Chriso. And if we could hear from Steve, that'd be great.
All right. It's interesting you think it's so spooky because that's where we live.
Oh right.
We live in the attic with the bats.
Oh, sorry. No aspersions on where you live, but it did remind me of The Shining.
I haven't seen The Shining, so I shall go and see that. But that's a 1930s building, and it's quite beautiful at places.
Oh, Well, I think it's. I just think the way that you've made everything symmetrical is amazing. So
yeah, I had to open all the doors and make sure no one watching didn't walk straight in. And I had to tote the sign out of the way and bang the head.
Oh.
just on a bar that I didn't know that existed.
You have to suffer for your art.
You do.
Yeah. Well done. Brilliant stuff. And for technique, we have Lucy and we have Serena. I just had to check there, sorry. And if we could hear from Lucy.
Hi, I took that picture. Me and Mum were
arguing over it.
We both wanted to take the picture, but on the other side, that what would win is taking a picture with her in it.
And it's a Medina house, which I watched being slowly ruined in a way. And I remember seeing it at the back. I remember seeing a police box. And you know I'm a Doctor Who addict. So I saw a TARDIS in the back garden before it was built up again. So it's got a special memory for me, this house.
Is it on the seafront?
It's near the seafront, near Morocco's ice cream. Yeah.
It was a squat for a while, wasn't it?
Yes, it was. And it was also a community food place. As part of
I think Chiche did their garden. It's a great shot.
Ask Chiche, because I think he does their garden.
Oh, brilliant. Right, okay. I want to get him to get me an autograph. I really do. I used to do... anyway, that's another story. I won't go into it.
Well, that's a great shot, Lucy. Well done.
Did you get down on your knees or something to get the angle, Lucy?
She got nearly run over. No, she did. No, she was in the middle of the street.
What I did, I made sure there was no cars in the way, and I just tried to take it from an angle. Yeah. I didn't want the whole building, because everyone does the whole building sometimes, or the whole architect. I wanted like the shape of it and the windows.
That's brilliant.
So I got a thing about windows.
Yeah.
On. And building.
Yeah, I've you know, again, with along with Steve here, you suffered for your art, and I think that's great. You know, people like, I can't, you know, obviously if someone does get hurt, it's not my fault, but like lying in the road, getting down on your knees and looking up, these are all great things, looking at the world in a different way.
Health and safety, dear.
Oh yeah, health and safety, sorry. If we could hear from Serena as well.
Hi. Oh, thank you. Some brilliant photos this week. That's a close-up of Five Guys Cafe, not far from the library, opposite Dock Reels there. And I think I was standing in the street nearly getting run over too. but it used to be an Italian restaurant and down below, but I think there must be flats upstairs, but all the reflections in the window caught my eye too. So I just closed in on it. Thank you. Yeah.
No, it's really good. Well done. And... for architecture, there's going to be no arguments in the Bennett household tonight because it's Teresa and Jez. If we could hear from Teresa first.
Yeah, and it will just be, Jez, would you believe he's had to run out the door with my 24-year-old son's football boots because he's gone to a match and forgot them. So good old dad has run out the door. So he's going to be gutted when he comes back. But anyway, again, a bit like Lucy was saying, I was conscious I didn't want to take the whole building. And actually, in front of the Amex, it's hopeless because there's so many cars and vans and, building and scaffolding. And I just thought this was a really interesting section of the Amex because of the different textures. And I made it black and white to please you. But no, it did look better at black and white. I was playing with it. But no, yeah, really pleased. And then Jez, I'll just say about his, we were beautiful walk, actually, by Glynde. This is one of the windmills by Glynde Opera House. And we were on one of our, big walks that we do. He was lying on the floor and trying all different angles and what have you. And yeah, that's how he got that.
Brilliant. Both of you have just, the textures and the angles and the lighting, I just think brilliant. So, and everyone's, I honestly, this week, It's been an absolute pleasure. They've all been brilliant. So, I mean, I think everyone deserves, everyone just gets better and better. It's really, really strong. So really well done. And next week, if Chris O could announce next week.
Yes, of course. Thank you. So the first to go is moving to every other week. The next thing will just be the music. And it can be a shot of a musical instrument. It can be a shot of a person playing an instrument, listening to music or DJing. It can be a shot of your favourite record, tips, think about the angle of the shot, think about the light and the shadow, think about the music. So it could be a landscape or diagonally, which is what a good perfect shot. Thank you.
Right, and any questions, please send them to Nickie and I, and please send your photos to Nickie. And just thank you again, everyone, for a brilliant, brilliant set of photos.
Can I just say that was Hengerton Cottage?
Ah. Oh, right. Okay. Thank you, Fran.
So hopefully everyone got that. We're moving to every other week.
Yeah, so not next week. So we've got 2 weeks to do it. That's great.
Loads of time. Brilliant. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you very much.
That was brilliant. Right, Harry, what's next?
Yeah, before you go on, did I ever sing a happy birthday song to Alexis?
Oh, happy birthday to Alexis. Have you had happy birthday sung to you yet, Alexis? Would you like us to sing to you again?
Well, I had it yesterday on the Radio Zoom show. So I feel that perhaps I'm milking it a bit too much to have it sung to me again. But the sentiment is really well, you know, thank you so much.
I had
a lovely day, and second one under lockdown. So
I think we should do it because Tim wasn't there yesterday.
All right, come on, let's do it.
Grandpa's birthday as well yesterday.
Happy birthday
to you.
Again.
Enough already.
Hip hip hooray.
Alexis, play happy birthday.
I've gone red.
Should
we sing for Gary?
Yeah.
Oh, yes.
Can we do it Wednesday?
Yes, Wednesday.
He's a jolly good fellow. And so say all of us.
We have a special daily show for Gary's birthday.
No. We haven't seen happy birthday to Chicho for 12 days ago.
Yes.
Chicho, happy birthday.
Stop it.
Happy birthday to you.
Okay, Harry, what's next?
Yes, yes. Next one is Padre and Daniels. with Liz Bishop.
Yay! Hello, Liz.
Yeah.
Hello. Yeah. The internet's a bit iffy here. Can you hear me all right?
Yeah, just about.
Yeah.
Next week, it would be Prince Philip's 100th birthday, but it's coming in 4 weeks' time.
Happy birthday to him.
So next week, I'm going to be singing You Never Walk Alone for Prince Philip by me.
Should we do the poetry?
Let's do the poetry.
This is going to be about
more. Let's do the poetry, guys. So everyone quiet for Liz.
Okay. Right, this is really quite a hard poem today. Stop it, they're making me laugh. This is quite a hard poem, but what I want you to think about is, as we're coming out of lockdown, the notion of coming through difficult times.
Oh no.
Gary,
come on, Liz, you can do this.
Naughty boys. Ignore those naughty boys.
Turn to move out from me while you're doing it.
No, I can ignore this. So coming out of really difficult times, if you can imagine a butterfly coming out of a chrysalis or a chicken coming out of an egg, where there's a bit of trepidation at first, a bit of anxiety, but then it looks as though it's going to come better. And it's
long. Can you move that, please?
It's called The Long Bench. And it's about coming out of something like lockdown. It's a post-COVID by a man called Jim Carroll. It's called The Long Bench. For the times ahead when we will be as if at either end of the long bench, where distance kept is love's measure, when words alone are not enough, and cued memories reach out to touch, let longing be a store of nut and seed that grows each day in strange hibernation, readying for its end, the sharing of the feast. So what I'd like you to do, that's quite a difficult poem, but what it's about really is having some difficulty and coming through and coming out to the reality of meeting people again, maybe. You know, the anxiety that you might feel after lockdown of being a bit difficult and then coming through and making it all work. So that's what I'd like you to try and do. Something where it's not easy, but it's opportunist and it's optimistic at the end. So a difficult one, been quite a difficult one. I've got a lot of silly boys around me at the moment.
I know, Liz, I think you're doing very well, trying to be very serious.
Could to be put it in the chat?
Liz will send it to me and I'll put it in the chat.
It's a really hard poem, but it is about the difficulty that we've all had, but we can see the opportunity ahead.
Brilliant.
Okay, Liz.
Right, Harry, what's next?
Okay, that's your news for Dad. Next one is, Strava Hero of the Week.
Strava Hero of the Week. I don't think Tim and Pedro have even chosen this week. Is Tim there, Liz, or is he mucking about?
No, Strava.
Don't stay there, Harry, because basically, if he hasn't said it, Nick, have you ever won Strava Hero of the Week?
You know, I have won, but I think it should go, even if he's done it before, to Lucas, who's really going out every evening, and he's so consistent.
He was top at the beginning of the week, wasn't he? He was amazing.
Doing it every week. He's going for it, and he's getting fit. He's doing his best.
Yeah. It showed on the tennis table today. It's looking good.
Great. So that's what it's all about. Nick. It's all about staying fit, running for table tennis. That's why I didn't realise, Teresa, like us two doing our couch to 5K running for 20 minutes. It's about, it helps your table tennis. Mm. Your fitness really does transfer. And we are a table tennis club, I keep reminding ourselves.
Talking about Lucas.
I know we're an entertainment industry. I realise that we're a corporation, but somewhere down there we do table tennis. Do we?
Yes. No, we did today.
Talking about Lucas, yesterday on the radio show, we saw him walking towards the car.
Oh, there you go.
That's good.
Oh, right, brilliant. Thank you, Harry. What's next then, Harry? What's next, Harry?
Oh, yeah, I do hear.
You said Nick.
Oh, it's Nick.
Is it me?
Yeah.
Is it capture competition?
Yay. Thank you, Harry.
Hello, everyone. Hello. We welcome Tim is back for the one and only caption competition. I'm glad that Chicho is here because it's possible that this week's caption was a Sicilian beach. Who knows? Right. Okay. If I could share my screen.
Yeah, he's made you co-host.
Genius. Now, I was quite strict this week because I had so many entrances that I've narrowed it down to the top six. So if you didn't get heard, if you don't hear yours, don't worry. It might get into it. It's a bit like Alexis's. I couldn't include them all, I'm afraid, because there were so many ideas. Okay, so here goes. These are the winners. I was very strict this week. I've really pared it down. From Pete, Serena's Pete. COVID conspiracy theorists meet for day out at the beach. Very true. Susie Oddball. Research suggests humans will do anything to avoid a red nose. Very good. From Liz. Faithful follow. This is an in-joke. It's about, well, you'll get it. It's about what you need 20p for. It's an in-joke. Faithful followers of guru Nick Creel fervently search in the sand for 20p pieces to follow his sacred quest to the answer, what do you need 20p for? My one from Nick. Tim persuades the BTTC to look for the 50p he lost on the beach. No, I thought that was good. Pippa's classic. Listen to Pippa. Genius. Life's a beach and then you dive. Thank you, Chris, for the salute. Serena, and the final one from Serena. Holiday makers desperate for foreign travel launch an escape bid. Okay, and this is next week's competition. It will be in the chat soon. It's the best photo we've ever had. Good saluting. It's this.
Oh, I love that picture.
Me? You think it was me that farted? No, whatever. Okay, that's the picture. That will be in the chat. Okay.
Mine was, this is like New York being with a bunch of nuns.
Yes. Chris, can you send your ones into the chat? Brilliant. Thank you, Chris. Okay, come up with one of these. This is going to be in the chat within 5 minutes. All right. Ooh. Take care,
guys. Thank you, Nick.
Speak later. Loving that.
Nick, it might be... Oh, my God, let's get Sophie on.
What? Sophie's actually coming on? I can't change this screen business. Oh, man, this is a nightmare.
You just have to exit. Exit at the top, your Facebook bit.
I'm trying to.
Of your Facebook at the top there, not your face, your Zoom. So press your Zoom thing at the top.
Oh, yeah, lovely. Couldn't see it. Sorry. Stop share. Thank you.
The last bit is Harry Fairchild's song choice.
Yay! What we got, Harry?
Well, today, on here, there's a song choice for me. And this one is called Fairchild Together by Jack.
And then there's the news at the end about Wednesday.
Mm.
song do we want, Harry?
Harry, say your song again to Tim.
Tim, hear me?
Yeah.
They Girl Together by Jack Johnson.
Jack Johnson?
Yeah, They Girl Together.
Oh, that's a nice song, Harry. I'm just playing it. It's very nice.
There's no combination of words I could put on the back of a postcard. No song that I could sing, but I can try for your heart. Our dreams, and they are made out of real things, like a shoebox of photographs with sepia tone loving. Love is the answer, at least for most of the questions of my heart, like why are we here and where do we go and knock on us so hard. It's not always easy and sometimes life can be deceiving. I'll tell you one thing, it's always better when we're together. It's always better when we're together. Yeah, we'll look at them stars and we're together. Well, it's always better when we're together. Yeah, it's always better when we're together. Moments just might find their way into my dreams tonight, but I know that they'll be gone when the morning light sings or brings new things. For tomorrow night you see that they'll be gone too. Too many things I have to do, but if all of these dreams might find their way into my day-to-day scene, I'd be under the impression I was somewhere in between. With only two, just me and you, not so many things we got to do or places we got to be. We'll sit beneath the mango tree now. Yeah, it's always better when we're together. We're somewhere in between together. Well, it's always better when we're together. Yeah, it's always better when we're together. They look so pretty when I sleep, yeah. And when I wake up, you look so pretty sleeping next to me. But there is not enough time, and there is no song I could sing, and there is no combination of words I could say, but I will still tell you one thing, we're better together.
Oh, that was a lovely song choice, Harry. Love that.
Hello.
Shall I mention about Wednesday?
Yeah, go for it, Fran.
So Wednesday, photo shoot!
Oh, you're
and
having
Nick,
your shoot.
And Nick's day. Home for Nando's.
Oh, no, I hope it all goes well. What time are you having that then, Fran?
Tim, what time?
Four. Photo shoot at four.
Nick said quarter past four.
What's possible?
Oh, brilliant. I hope it goes well.
Tim, can you make it 4 o'clock? I'm on a bit of a deadline.
Listen, I can't get there for four. I'm at Morescombe. I have to lock up. I can't get there for four.
Someone else can lock up. We'll get Sam to lock up, Nick, on Wednesday.
Yeah, but
Sam's responsible.
No, Nick, no, you can't.
I try, but I can't. I definitely can't. I can't leave till 3:30. Anyway, I'll get there as early as I can.
We'll get Sam to lock up at Boston and come back for 4. We'll leave Sam the keys.
You don't care because I'm not invited.
Yeah, someone take the place.
So take the station offline. That's what we say. Yeah, we're not DJs.
Also, Nick is paying for Nando's.
I thought you were, Fran. You said you were.
No, you are.
You told me you saved up all year. You told me you saved up all year so that we could do this, Fran.
No, you
changed your mind.
What's going on, Fran?
He's teasing you, Fran.
I know all I trust.
Text her. Yeah, exactly, Steve.
Yeah.
Oh, lovely show, everybody.
Chris, do you want to mention about radio show?
No, not yet, Fran. My announcement is. It's not just about Thursday TV radio show. It's me and Harry together.
And me.
And Fran. If you could send your song requests in the radio show Zoom on the WhatsApp chat. And it's all about the 90s and the 80s music. If you could send them in, you can. And I wanted to say to you, in the next couple of months, I'm coming back to the club 4 times.
Woo! And the host on Thursday is Harry. Your co-host is me and Chris.
Yeah, I didn't know that. I thought that your host is going to be me. I thought that I might do a co-host is 5 minutes and just go clean. But I really want to hear music.
Thank you, Teresa. Harry, co-host. Lovely to see you all. Thanks to everyone for your help at Molscombe today and at the club. Fantastic. Miss you. See you all soon.
Jacob said yesterday, people can come on if people can come and watch us if they want to.
Yeah, they want. Yeah.
Well, I know Kerry will, I think.
Cheers.
What's up, Sophie, Nick? I did ask her.
How did the clubs go today, Tim? And Teresa,
really good. We had juniors in the morning and different batch in the afternoon at the club, which is brilliant.
Yeah,
buzzing. Yeah,
brilliant, really, really, really good. And same again tomorrow.
Yeah.
Don't forget
Teresa, will you be there for Wednesday to see us?
Oh no, because I'll probably be I finish at 3:30, so I don't think I'll be there. But I hope all goes well.
See you then, Fran.
You in the morning,
Teresa. Cheers, everyone.